We want to find each product and write the terms in descending order. We first have negative 4 times the quantity 4x plus 7. So to find this product, we distribute the negative 4. So we'll have negative 4 times 4x plus negative 4 times 7. So negative 4 times 4x would be negative 16x. And negative 4 times 7 would be negative 28, or just minus 28. These terms are in descending order because the x term has degree 1 and the constant term has degree 0. Next, we have a binomial times a binomial. And if we understand distribution, we can just think of this as double distribution. To find this product, we can think of distributing the 2x, then distributing the 7. Notice when multiplying a binomial and a binomial, we have 4 products. We multiply every term in the first binomial by every term in the second binomial. So first we have 2x times x, that would be 2x to the second. And then we have 2x times negative 3, that's negative 6x, or minus 6x. And then we have 7 times x, that would be plus 7x. And then we have 7 times negative 3, that's negative 21, or minus 21. Now combining like terms, notice how we have 2x terms here. Negative 6x plus 7x would be equal to positive 1x, or just x. So this simplifies to 2x squared plus x minus 21. Next we have the quantity 3x minus 5 squared. Now there's no shortcuts here. We want to expand this and then find the product like we did above when multiplying two binomials. So this is equal to the quantity 3x minus 5 times the quantity 3x minus 5. And because we have a binomial times a binomial, we'll have 4 products. We'll first distribute the 3x, then distribute the negative 5. So we'll have 3x times 3x, that's 9x to the second, or 9x squared. And then we have 3x times negative 5, that's negative 15x, or minus 15x. And then we have negative 5 times 3x, that's also negative 15x, or minus 15x. And then we have negative 5 times negative 5, that's positive 25, or plus 25. And once again, we have 2x terms here. Negative 15x minus 15x would be negative 30x. So we have 9x squared minus 30x plus 25. And again, these terms are in descending order. We have the degree 2 term, the degree 1 term, and the degree 0 term. Next, we have a binomial times a trinomial. But we can still use this distribution idea. We first want to distribute the 2x into the trinomial. So we have 3 products here. Then we distribute the 3 into the trinomial. So we have 3 more products here, giving us a total of 6 products. So 2x times negative 3x squared, that'd be negative 6x to the third. And then we have 2x times negative 2x, that's negative 4x squared, or minus 4x squared. And then we have 2x times 3, that'd be plus 6x. We've got 3 more products. 3 times negative 3x squared, that'd be negative 9x squared, or minus 9x squared. And then we have 3 times negative 2x, that's negative 6x, or minus 6x. And then finally we have 3 times 3, that's positive 9, or plus 9. The last step, we'll combine like terms. There's only one x cubed term, so we have negative 6x to the third. There are two x squared terms. We have negative 4x squared minus 9x squared. That would be negative 13x squared, or minus 13x squared. We have two x terms. We have 6x minus 6x. That would actually be 0 because these are opposites. And then we have the constant term plus 9. So this would be our product. I hope you found this helpful.